Hello, and welcome to my second installment of my little tour around Gray Abbey and around the local landmarks as I share with you some of the biblical connections that I have found in the 3 years that I've been living here in this area. Today, I find myself standing on South Island. People say there is an island for every day of the year in Strangford Loch. Now, that is a disputed figure. Some people believe there's many, many less than that. But there are a lot of islands on Strangford Loch, and there are certainly two here off the coast of Gray Abbey. I'm standing on South Island, and just over my head here, you can see Mid Island. These islands are really part of the history of Gray Abbey. They're part of the village identity. Many people came out and played here as children, come out for family picnics, but maybe most famously, the Mid Island there was used in World War II as an observation point for the RAF pilots who used the loch behind me here for practice runs in their bombers before they headed off to war. And many people alive still remember those days. But an island, the definition of an island, is a subcontinental piece of land surrounded by water. And certainly, as you can see, we are surrounded by water here. But these two islands off Gray Abbey, South Island that I'm standing on, and then Mid Island out behind me, are a little bit different. Because as you can see, just up here, there's a little causeway. There's a causeway which connects South Island to Mid Island, and then there's another little causeway on the far side of Mid Island that connects Mid Island to the main body of land. The main body of land, which is the Ards Peninsula. And these causeways were created by the tide. The tide comes in and out past the islands here, and these little gaps between them, the tide has washed up piles of stones, meaning that it is possible to walk between the islands even when the tide comes in. Now, when the tide's really high, you can't walk between the islands, but today we can, and I have. That's how I got out here. As I think of these two separate entities connected to the main body of the peninsula, it makes me think of 1 Corinthians chapter 12. Paul there talks about a body made up of many different parts, but they're all connected. They are all one body. What he's talking about is the Church of Jesus Christ. All the people around the world who know and love Jesus are all connected. Obviously, that's not a physical connection, but it is a spiritual connection. We are all connected through Christ. These islands were connected by a force of nature. But for us in the church, we are not naturally connected to Jesus Christ. In fact, by our very nature, we are disconnected. But thankfully, God, because of his love and his grace and his mercy, sent Jesus to die for us. Jesus came willingly to the cross to die for our sins. He rose from that cross. All of this was by the power of the Holy Spirit. And that Holy Spirit speaks to us, reveals our position, our disconnected position, points us to Jesus. And when we place our trust and put our faith in Jesus, we can be connected to the main body. Just the way this little causeway connects these two islands, we can be connected to Jesus Christ, part of that great body which is the church. Now, there are lots of benefits here in our lifetime for being part of that body. There are also great benefits eternally for us to be part of that body, and those benefits are long conversations. It takes a long time to work through that. If you want to talk a little bit more about that, 11 o'clock on a Sunday morning, we'll be there. A number of people will be happy to share with you. You can connect to us through Facebook and through our church website. But just to finish off this little short vlog today, I would just want to say that if you are a Christian, if you have placed your trust in Jesus Christ, if you have your faith in Jesus, you are part of that body. There's no doubt about it. But sometimes as Christians, we can feel isolated. We feel we're maybe not part of that body at all, and we question that. But you are part of the body through Jesus Christ. And if you're feeling a little bit isolated or disconnected, go and speak to a Christian friend, pray together, read the Bible together, and be just renewed in your sense of connection to Jesus. And maybe you're watching this here and you're not a Christian, but you know that there's something missing in your life, and you just need a connection that you haven't found yet. There's a good chance that connection is a connection through Christ to the church, to the body of believers all around the world. So I hope today that as you watch this little vlog, that you will be reminded that you are part of the body or you've been made aware that you can be part of the body. Go and talk to someone about those things and share this, what we call the good news. Until we see you again next week, I pray you'll be blessed and know God's blessing.